This sort of find is truly exceptional. They don't come along even every decade, every 100 years.
And what they tell us about the people who made them. Dig to unravel the mystery of the Moor. If it's Bronze Age Britain you're after, then this is the place to come. Because beyond this woodland is the finest relic we have of this ancient landscape. Dartmoor has the finest preserved Bronze Age landscape, not only in Britain, but in the whole of Europe. Come to the High Moor and you'll find enigmatic stone rows and cosmically aligned standing stones, the purpose of which we can only guess. But what we do know is that just over 4,000 years ago, there was a technological and cultural revolution, with Dartmoor right at the heart. There are more than 5,000 of these hut circles, showing a vibrant community living and working on the moor. Despite this, discoveries of artifacts on the moor have been few and far between. A combination of the acidic nature of the soil and grave robbing have left us few significant finds, until now. The chance discovery of a buried kist or stone box on White Horse Hill, high on the northern moor, is giving us a glimpse into the ancient past. The kist had been untouched for nearly 4,000 years, until 2011, when archaeologists from the national park levered off the lid.
That's it. That's it.
There we go.
What they found astonished them. Organic remains very rare in the harsh conditions of Dartmoor. They found a cremation wrapped in an animal pelt and containing a delicate bracelet studded with tin beads. A textile fragment with detailed leather fringing and a unique coiled bag, scans of which reveal more treasures within. Jane's come to the Wiltshire Conservation Lab, where they're hoping to reveal the secrets of that coiled bag.
We were thinking that might be sort of remains of mineralised thread, because you see the way it's kind of going through the perforation in the middle.
Yeah.
Today it's conservator Helen Williams' job to delicately remove the contents for the first time in nearly 4,000 years.
The level of preservation we've got is amazing. So to find an object like this with contents still intact is fantastic. So it's very exciting.
Okay.
But then something altogether more unusual.
Well, it's sort of around an object sort of about that size. It's got a sort of two slightly domed surfaces. It almost looks like a very small yo-yo. It would have been worn sort of in the ear.
I don't remember studs being recorded in any other excavation from this period.
Well, it's a year since our cameras have been here, and Helen, I have to say, it looks like you've been incredibly busy. All of a sudden, they're looking fantastic. The person who was buried was... Organic finds are incredibly rare, as the material usually rots away. Well, that for me is the most interesting find, but that, I have to say, is so impressive. And a year ago, that kind of looked like a cow pat, didn't it? Considering it's 4,000 years old, I have to say, it's astonishing.
Amazing doesn't really do them justice, I don't think. We've got the most extraordinary assortment of finds. We've got things like the tin, we've got the tin bead, we've got the tin studs on the bracelet. This is the first hard evidence we've got suggesting that Bronze Age people were actually working tin on Dartmoor.
In fact, it's the earliest evidence of tin ever found in the southwest. But even more remarkable are the organic finds, and in particular, the wooden ear studs. Well, these look absolutely... Do I pick it up?
Mm, absolutely.
Divine. The most astonishing thing is, we think these are the ear studs, is that you can actually see the annual growth rings on this. So you can almost say that is an ear stud taken from a piece of wood that was maybe 6 or 7 years old at least.
Any idea what type of wood?
We think that's spindle wood.
I mean, wouldn't it be fantastic if we could try and actually see if we can make them today?
I think you're throwing down the gauntlet here, Jane.
I just might be. It's called experimental archaeology.
Basically, I need a panel of experts. Someone to work wood, weave hair, carve amber, cut shale, smelt tin, and then fashion it into the incredibly exquisite jewellery of the day, all as they would have done in the Bronze Age. How difficult can that be? When our princess walked this land, it looked very different. We know it was heavily wooded with oak and hazel, and that these raw materials formed the basis of their lives, their buildings, their tools, and their jewellery. But very little of this organic material has survived, and it's what makes our next find, the ear studs, so special. They're made from the wood of the spindle tree, and I have a piece freshly cut from a Dartmoor hedgerow, ready for our next task.
Well, this is where I came in. The BBC contacted me in 2013 and asked my opinion as to how these ear studs were made. To me, there was absolutely no doubt they were turned on a lathe, and obviously this would be the earliest known example of wood turning in the UK, if this was true. So I travelled to Dartmoor along with a Bronze Age chisel, made of bronze of course, and a little homemade round nose chisel for doing the inside of the ear studs. The next question is, what sort of lathe was used? Well, it would have been a reciprocating lathe, in other words, one that goes backwards and forwards. It could have been a bow lathe or a strap lathe, and it could have been operated by one or two people. These are examples of bow lathes. And then we have a few illustrations of strap lathes just to set the scene. Luckily, we have these wonderfully turned artifacts. What we don't have, of course, is the lathe itself. Neither do we have any components. And so the actual makeup of the lathe is pure speculation, but it would have been a very simple device. And the two main elements of such a lathe would be two points between which the wood to be turned could freely rotate, and rotated by way of a strap, a cord, or a bow. Right, so it's off to Dartmoor.
Can I introduce you, Stuart? Yeah. Stuart King, master carpenter, has agreed to help. Spindle. So before, presumably, you put onto the lathe, you're going to have to do some fashioning and some whittling.
Quite a bit, yes.
Can we leave that with you, then?
Yep, I'll go off and do some work.
Discuss ear studs.
OK, see you later.
Fabulous. See you later, Stuart. Tell me why this find is so special.
Wooden finds like this are extremely rare. They're probably the earliest evidence for turning of wood from the UK.
The earliest in the UK ever?
It's basically pushed back our evidence for wood turning in the UK half a millennium, 500 years.
Well, that's nicely written.
Yeah, basically, I need someone to do that. OK, long strokes.
Yep.
Keep going, then. That's it.
Isn't that brilliant? What do you think, Richard?
That looks really good. It's very simple technology. There's no reason why they couldn't have used something like
that. Look, here's an original bronze tool, just to prove
it's... There we go.
It's slower, but it will work.
Doesn't really get any better than this, does it? Dartmoor spindle, Bronze Age hut circle in the background, ancient techniques, and very effective as well.
And that lovely razzle of the tool, which must have echoed all over Dartmoor at one time.
I like the picture you're painting.
That's pretty well good enough, I think.
So smooth inside as well.
Yeah, and that's straight from the tool. Now we remove that from the lathe. It is giving a very similar finish to that on the originals.
Just like a 4,000-year-old Stanley knife.
What we can do now is break that off there.
See, by magic.
Tidy up the other side. There we are, finished.
There we have a spindle ear stud à la Brett. Now, Richard, how similar do you think it is? And what do you think of this fantastic process we've gone through?
I think that's really marvellous, because we've ended up with a product that's very, very similar to the originals. And you've shown that a skilled person using very simple technology and bronze tools can make them. So that's wonderful.
Well, my journey is nearly at an end, and I'm ready to bring all our efforts together. From smelting tin on Dartmoor and working it into a beautiful bead and studs to our painstaking bracelet weaving. And let's not forget our wood turning. Alison just needs to string the necklace incorporating our tin bead, and then I can dress our model. We have a lovely model called Claire here. Come round.
That's so
amazing.
That is beautiful.
That's so detailed, isn't it?
Linda, that's wonderful.
And the interesting thing as well, Alison, the colour of the bead just directs your eye towards the amber and then the tin.
Yes, absolutely. It's just great.
Yes.
Yeah. Bling.
Jane, the ear studs.
They're absolutely extraordinary. Beautiful. Actually, they look very attractive. Would you buy a pair?
Yes, I would.
There you go. You look beautiful.
It looks wonderful.
Yes.
In remaking these wonderful objects, I had no idea how hard it would be or how much we would learn. It's given me a vivid insight into how incredibly skilled these ancient craftspeople were and how sophisticated their society must have been.